In this lecture, we will study about some of the text entry components available in java.awt package. To be specific, we will look into two of them, text field and text area. Let's look at the first one, that is text field. Text field will help you to create a component where you can enter some text as well as edit that text. And it will help you to only edit single line of text. So you see two examples here. One is a text field that is used for taking a name, another one for taking the password. Editing of the text means you can cut, copy, paste the text. So you see here there is some text that I have selected. Now I can do some editing with this selected text. There are constructors available. First one is a default constructor. The second constructor helps us to create a text field with the specified number of columns. So for example, if I write here number of columns as 10, then in that case text field will be wide enough to show 10 columns, where in each column one character is displayed. This no way means that you will be allowed to enter only 10 characters. If the length of this text field is 10, and if I enter more than 10 characters, then the characters will start scrolling on this side. The third constructor is a constructor which takes string as a parameter, and this string is used for initializing the text field. That means whatever string you enter here will be displayed in the text field. The last constructor is where you combine these two things together. So first is the text with which you want to initialize, and second one is the number of columns that will decide the width of the text field in a GUI. Let's look at some of the methods of this class. So first is getText, second is setText. SetText method will help you to put a string inside a text field, and getText will help you to fetch that string from the text field. The next method is getSelectedText. This will help you to fetch the selected text from the text field. So if I go to the previous slide, here you will see CS is selected. Okay, so you know how to do that selection with the help of a mouse, and then you can fetch the selected text by using this method in the program. Then the text field can be an editable text field or non-editable text field. So you see an example of a non-editable text field here. This is little grayed out. Okay, so compare it with the text field that you see here. So in an editable text field, I'll be allowed to make entries. I'll be allowed to edit the text. Here in this text field, I will not be allowed to enter a string, or if already a string is displayed, I will not be allowed to make changes to that string. So such a text field is called as non-editable. So I can set the editable property to true or false by using this method setEditable, and I pass that true or false as a parameter here. I can check whether a particular text field is editable or not by using this isEditable method, which returns a boolean value. So if it returns true, that means a text field is editable. Then in the previous slide, you also saw that for the password, there are question marks that are visible here. Okay, what this means is that in the password field, if I'm trying to enter some characters, instead of actually displaying those characters, question marks are displayed. So to get that effect, there is a method called as setEchoCHAR, to which you can give the character that should be displayed when you actually enter the characters from the keyboard. So if I want that question mark should be displayed, this parameter that you see here, I will pass that as question mark. I can also fetch from the text field, which is the EchoCHAR that is used by that text field. Let's see one program here. So usual imports at the top, there is an applet tag, there is a class which is extending applet. Okay, so there are two text fields created, one is name, another is pass. And inside init method, you will see there are two labels created. So one is name p, another is pass p. And you'll see how the labels are created. So in the label, I want to display name and I want to display the password. Okay, and both of them will be right aligned. After that, there are two text fields created. Okay, so one the text fields that are declared here are defined here. So two text fields are defined here, and you see the parameters here. One is 12, another is 8. So this means that the name text field will be big enough to hold 12 characters at a time, and password will be big enough to hold 8 characters. And you will see here how for the password field the echo char is set as question mark. Okay, so this is how in the password field when I enter some character it will be displayed as question mark. So I have created two labels, I have created two text fields. So next step is we have to add them. So we call add again and again, and add has to be called in the same sequence in which I want to add the component. So first thing I want to add is the label. Second, I want to add the name text field. Then third thing I want to add is password label. And fourth thing that I want to add is the pass text field or password text field. Okay. So once I do that, this is the effect that you're going to get. So this is a label, this is name text field, a label, and the pass text field. Let's go on to the next text entry component, which is text area. Okay, so text area is a multi-line editor. So that's the difference between a text field and text area. Text field will allow single line entry and single line editing, whereas text area allows multi-line editing. Okay, so look at the constructor default. Second one is which is taking number of rows and number of columns as the parameter. Okay, so number of rows will decide how many lines will be displayed, and number of columns will decide how many in each line, how many characters will be displayed. Okay, again, this is in the visible area. That does not mean that you will not be able to enter more rows and more columns. Okay, so whatever is not visible, you'll be able to see them using scroll bars. So we'll see an example and come back to this point. Then there is a constructor here where a string is entered as a parameter, and this is again for initializing and displaying the string in the text area. Then the next one is the combination of these two. So this is initializing string, number of rows and number of columns. And the last one is interesting, where you have a string to be displayed in the text area, number of rows, number of columns, and then you can also take a decision as to how scroll bars will be displayed. Okay, so let's look at what is going to be the value that I can give for S bars. So here you see what possible values I can give to S bars. So first is scroll bars underscore both. Okay, so this means both vertical as well as horizontal scroll bars will be visible. The second indicates that I don't want either horizontal or vertical. So none of these scroll bars will be visible. Meaning of these two now is clear. Only horizontal will be visible, only vertical will be visible. Okay. Then there are methods. So whatever methods you can use with text field, same methods you can also use with text area. Apart from that, there are two methods that are of interest to us. One is append method, and it takes string as a parameter. Append method will help us to add the string to the end of the text area, and insert method will help me to insert or add a string at a particular index number. Whatever is displayed in a text area, okay, whatever string is displayed in a text area, you can assume that each character in the string has an index number starting with 0. Okay. So this is how now you can figure out the index of every character, and you can also figure out where exactly you want to insert this string. So let's see here a simple example. Okay, so go through the imports. There is an applet tag, a class that is extending applet, init method in which there is some string, okay, that is initialized. Backslash n here is to go to the next line. Here you will see 2 backslash n, so therefore there are 2 lines that are left, and the rest of the code. Here you will see how text area is created. We write new text area, val is a string that will be put inside text area, 7 is number of rows that will be visible, 30 is number of characters that will be visible. Once this text area is created, this is added to the applet by using add method. You see the effect here. Okay, so now in the program the number of rows were given as 7 and actual number of rows in val are more than that. That is why you see a vertical scroll bar appearing. Similarly, number of columns I had given as 30, whereas here I want to display more than 30 characters on a single line. That is why vertical scroll bar appears. So if you do not specify what kind of scroll bars you require, in that case scroll bars will appear as required. So if they are required, if they are needed, only then they will be appearing, otherwise they will not be appearing. We stop here.